Cheers, VG. Ice cold beer. Because today is going to be the hottest day of the year here in Denmark, with more than 30 degrees Celsius. And anything above 22 degrees Celsius is way too hot for me, so I'm going to sweat like a pig today. Oh God. Well, I also chose this hottest day of the year to take a trip to Copenhagen and visit Kenneth's record store again, the Fona in Copenhagen, to look at more music on vinyl records. I said in my last vinyl update that I were going to seek more of these music on vinyl pressings, so I went in today and I went a little crazy, but what the hell, I had the money for it, so well, let's start with the first one, which is Heart. What's it called? Dog and Butterfly. It looks like this. These music on vinyl reissues. Should we take a look at this sticker here? These music on vinyl reissues, they sound really good and they are mastered really good, but I don't really know. It's like the cover is just a photocopy or something like that. I don't think they are the text is not as sharp as they should be, in my opinion. Don't know if you can see it there. It will probably not show. But I got this Heart, Dog and Butterfly album. This is my first Heart album. So I'm very much looking forward to listen to this. I just got home just about an hour ago, so I haven't listened to them. But the other music on vinyl pressings I have, they sound fantastic, so I hope these do too. It came with this insert with lyrics on one side and the vinyl comes in these polylined inner sleeve. Should we take a look at one of the labels there? I don't know if it's, yes, it's possible to see it. So yeah, actually this label also kind of looks like just a photocopy. Don't know if I like that too much, but of course if they haven't got access to the real source, so maybe it can be difficult to make a exact copy. Cheers again. The next one is my second record by Aerosmith, Rocks. A lot of people in the VC have told me to get this one, so I did. And this is a Record Store Day reissue from Music on Vinyl, and it's actually numbered. Can see it right there in the top corner, number 1400. So yeah, very much looking forward to listening to that one too. And all these music on vinyl comes in these bags, but I took it out of this bag so I could show you. I would look, and as you can see, it's there's the music on vinyl sticker And there's glare, so you can probably can't see it. But yeah, I don't really know if it's a Record Store reissue from this year. It has 2014 on it, so maybe it was last year. I don't know. But also came with this inner sleeve. I have a hard time speaking English today, I'm sorry, but I will do my best. And also this is kind of, looks like a photocopy. I don't know if I like that too much. And the record came in this black polyline inner sleeve with the Columbia label there. Also has the music on vinyl written on the label. Great stuff. Then I found this Vandenberg album. Also music on vinyl reissue. And this is a exclusive limited edition, individually numbered on colored vinyl. So this also is also numbered. You can see the number down there and the bottom there. Yeah, number 218. This is some 80s heavy metal. And it came in the, once again, the black polylined inner sleeve. And the vinyl looks like this on the blue marbled vinyl and the label there. Well, I'm not a fan of colored vinyl, but as long as it's not the picture disc, I guess I'm okay. I'm a good old fashioned guy that likes my black vinyl. Cheers again. Take a look at Gary Moore shredding in the back there. I have a story to tell a little bit later when I'm going to show the last object. So and the next music on vinyl reissue is Opeth Deliverance. This is a 2 LP set. Doesn't have any inserts or anything, but well, again, there is looks a little bit like it's just a photocopy. What the hell? And here's one of the LPs here, and again, one of the black polylined inner sleeves. This is what the side D label looks like. Opeth Deliverance. I am a huge fan of Opeth. I have become a huge fan of Opeth for the last year or so. I just love them. I love the heaviness they bring. And the growling too, and then they suddenly switch to just a rock song where Michael sings in his normal voice and everything sounds phenomenal. And this one should be one of those kind of not so heavy albums. And I didn't have this one, so I got this. And the next one is the Jimi Hendrix Experience Axis Bold as Love. This is one of those album covers that I don't like too much because they go this way. And here's the inside. Jimi Hendrix record. Great stuff. Also, music on vinyl came in this bag. With the sticker there, what does it say? 180 gram audiophile LP pressing. It also says the authorized Hendrix family edition. All analog remaster from the original two track master tapes by Jimmy's original engineer. But there's the sticker there. And the music on vinyl. Exclusively remastered on 180 gram vinyl. And it came with this booklet. See if it's possible to show some of it here. It's hard to flip through it. Yeah, great booklet there. And again, it came with the English is terrible today. It came in the pulley line inner sleeve. Here's one of the labels and the single label right there. Looks great. So my second Jimi Hendrix album in my collection. Then another music on vinyl reissue, Depeche Mode, Music for the Masses. I thought I would keep this in the bag to just to show you that music on vinyl ships them in these kind of flake sleeves, even though they are not, but looks a little bit like them. So Depeche Mode, but this looks a little bit better. It just doesn't just look like a photocopy. It's actually a little bit embossed too in the picture there, and the little logo on the top of the Depeche Mode there. So looks great. Looks like this inside. Yeah, this is clear and crisp, not like the other pressings. And came with this inner sleeve as well. That looks fantastic. And the black inner sleeve. Why does it stop all the time? Well, it came in this black inner sleeve, and should we just take a look at the custom label there? Looks like that, and the label on the other side looks like this. Beautiful. Normally, I don't buy, when I'm out looking for records and CDs, I don't buy a record if I already have it on CD, and vice versa. I don't buy a CD if I have it on vinyl. But in this case, I have this on CD, but I just would like to try to listen to how this music on vinyl reissue sounds, and maybe, just maybe, I will be getting the other reissues from Music on Vinyl by Depeche Mode, because I'm a huge fan of Depeche Mode. So let's see how this sounds. Looking forward to that. Let's have the last sip of the beer here. Then the last one I got. I found this Gary Moore CD, Blues for Greenie. And this is Gary Moore Gary Moore made a tribute album with songs written by Peter Green. And there's a story about Peter Green and Gary Moore. Peter Green had this Les Paul that kind of looked like, kind of looks like the one that Gary Moore are playing on right there. I don't know if it is actually the one, but Peter Green had this 59 Les Paul that he sold to Gary Moore one day because Gary Moore thought it was absolutely fantastic to play at. And that guitar is actually the holy grail with guitars. Today, that guitar is worth $2 million, that 59 Les Paul. And today it's owned by Kirk Hammett from Metallica. So I know that Kirk Hammett didn't pay $2 million for it, because the owner that has it, had it at the time that Kirk Hammett bought it were in money troubles, and he needed money. So I have read that Kirk Hammett bought it a little bit cheaper, but it's worth $2 million today. And you've probably seen the picture I posted of it. So, but I found this. This is a reissue from 2002 of the album, Digital Remastered Edition. I don't know if that's a good thing or not in these Loudness Wars days, but I hope it sounds good. That was it from me, ladies and gentlemen. Have a nice Saturday. Bye bye.